शुरू करें।
तो थोड़े दिन पहले मेरी दादी ने मेरे से पूछा कि रिया चक्रवर्ती कौन है। माइंड यू, दिस इज अ 91 ईयर ओल्ड वुमन हु कैन बेरली रिमेंबर द नेम्स ऑफ द मेडिसिंस दैट कीप हर गोइंग। पर वो रिया का नाम इतनी बार सुन चुकी थी दैट शी हैड टू आस्क हु शी इज। डोंट गेट मी रॉन्ग, आई थिंक द वे द इंडियन मीडिया हैज कवर्ड दिस अर्थ शैटरिंग केस हैज बीन स्पेक्टेक्युलर।
फिल्मी पर्दे का धोनी असल जिंदगी में टाइम्ड आउट क्यों हो गया?
क्या सुशांत सिंह राजपूत अय्याश थे?
रिया के काले जादू के सामने फेल सुशांत।
रिया चक्रवर्ती के लिए आज रियल इंटरव्यू का दिन है।
रिया, आप ड्रग्स पार्टीज ऑर्गेनाइज करती थी रिया?
अगर कल इस समय रिया की गिरफ्तारी हो जाए तो पूरे भारत में दिवाली बन जाएगी।
मैं हूँ 4000 mAh की बैटरी, यानी एक बार फोन चार्ज किया तो घंटों तक का आराम। अब आपको बार बार फोन चार्ज करने का कोई झंझट नहीं।
I just threw in that last one for fun. But god damn, kya crazy hai ye log? And how ironic is it that they're accusing someone else of using drugs? Matlab inka kuch alag level pe chal raha hai. But I'm so used to seeing these idiot street news with such balance and finesse, it's not even funny anymore. I mean, pretty much the same thing happened with the Arushi Talwar case. Ye log journalist kehlane ke utne hi layak hai jitna Viral Bhayani hai. एक्चुअली आई थिंक वो बेटर जर्नलिस्ट है। वो सिर्फ ये बताता है कि सारा अली खाना जिम गई थी। वो ये नहीं बोलता सारा अली खाना जिम गई थी इसका मतलब वो स्टीरॉइड्स ले रही है, चलो एक घंटे का डिबेट करते हैं। पर हमेशा से तो ऐसा नहीं था। So how did we go from this?
This is an election that's not being fought on hard local issues that state elections usually are, that they're issueless at one level,
to this.
रिया चक्रवर्ती बोलती है ड्रग दो ड्रग दो ड्रग दो ड्रग दो ड्रग दो।
जानने के लिए देखते रहिए वो अनस्क्रिप्टेड।
दुश्मनों का काल आ रहा है रफाल।
राम लला हम आएंगे और 2020 में मिशन पूरा हुआ, मंदिर वही बनाएंगे।
क्या रावण दुनिया का पहला पायलट था?
भाई रावण कौन था?
अगर चीन उकसाएगा तो कीमत चुकाएगा।
रिया चक्रवर्ती गिरफ्तार हो गई है।
For most of our history, news was literally the plural of new. It was anything new people heard about and shared and was limited by physical proximity and word of mouth. But that changed because of a guy called Gutenberg. Actually, because of his printing press. मतलब printing का concept तो काफी time से था, लेकिन Gutenberg's printing press made it way more efficient. It made it super easy to spread information beyond our immediate surroundings. The funny thing is, early newspapers were quite similar to the ones we have today. They were mostly partisan and were seen as persuaders. मतलब उनका काम था अपने readers को convince करना, चाहे वो साबुन खरीदने के लिए हो या किसी party के लिए vote करने के लिए हो.
That persuasive logic at the beginning of the world wars, during the Second World War and during Stalin's time in Russia and then in later in China, it acquired a very damaging result. So from the Second World War, this mass warfare meeting mass media and then operationalizing, and then we saw the horrors, you know, where what happened in Stalin's Russia or what Mao's Cultural Revolution, it is not possible without mass media. So when the horror of that persuasion began to come, all these questions of ethics and all that began.
Long story short, everyone realized that information can be a really powerful tool. And that इसके इस्तेमाल से कुछ भी किया जा सकता है। It could raise armies, incite violent mobs, or destabilize whole nations. लोग समझने लगे कि बॉस किसी भी न्यू इन्फॉर्मेशन को न्यूज नहीं मान सकते, थोड़े कायदे कानून लागू करने पड़ेंगे। And this gave us the modern concept of news. News was supposed to be information about current events through the testimony of observers and witnesses to events. It should be based on facts and not opinions, and must strive to put the public interest and the truth above their own self-interest or assumptions. Wow, English. It kind of became an unsaid rule that the discipline of verification is what separated journalism from other forms of communication. जैसे प्रोपेगेंडा, एडवर्टाइजिंग, फिक्शन या एंटरटेनमेंट। और इंडिया में भी यही मॉडल फॉलो हो रहा था। द अर्ली न्यूज़पेपर्स इन इंडिया वर ओन्ड बाय रिच बिजनेसमैन एंड दे अर्न मोस्ट ऑफ देयर रेवेन्यू थ्रू सब्सक्रिप्शंस एंड सम थ्रू एडवर्टाइजिंग। दे वर मोर और लेस अनबायस्ड एंड दे इवन एक्टेड एज वॉचडॉग्स ओवर द प्रोपेगेंडा फील्ड ब्रिटिश न्यूज़पेपर्स। मगर इंडिया की इंडिपेंडेंस के बाद न्यूज़पेपर्स का रोल थोड़ा सा चेंज हो गया।
The mood of the country at independence was not about scandals, it was about hope and nation building. So they participated in nation building. Here too, if you see some of the old established papers, they were very centrist. The first scandal started emerging in the 50s, then Parliament was taking the lead in asking questions, and then the newspapers used to cover it. There was no independent investigative report. All that changed in the 70s when there was an emergency. Papers were clamped down upon, editors were thrown into jail. The Indian Express stood up, statesmen stood up against the government. And when the emergency ended, a new era began. Many of these papers started investigating. It was a pretty glorious era. And these papers had their solid circulations, solid followings. Editors were well known, respected. Then it was like a spring bursting.
The 70s and 80s saw newspapers coming into their own and truly becoming the fourth pillar of our democracy. TV news ke bare mein baat karna bekaar hai kyunki us time pe sirf ek channel tha, which was run by the government, and their coverage was often biased towards the ruling party, which at that point was always Congress. However, all of this changed because of Saddam Hussein. I mean, not directly. Basically, when Saddam uncle ne Kuwait mein ghusbait kari, to America aa gaya, jaise hamesha aata hai. And this was the start of the Gulf War, which eventually led to the economic reforms and the liberalization of 1991. And like all other industries, the news industry also became open to many more private players and thus became highly competitive.
So they came up with innovations, and one of the innovations was the paper costs 2 rupees in your household, but I'm going to give it to you for 1. I'm a subscriber. I don't want 2 papers. I'm happy with 1. For 1 rupee. If you give a newspaper for 1 rupee, the circulation grows. But the cost of producing the paper still is 12 rupees, 14 rupees, etc. So who's covering the gap? So the advertisers started covering the gap.
So the newspapers went to advertisers and marketing companies and were like, hey man, aapko apna sabun bechna hai hamare newspaper mein? We have a pretty big reader base. And eventually, the ads started becoming more important than the actual news.
Once that happened, the power moved to the advertiser. Till then, the power was in the editorial. Meanwhile, don't forget one thing. Journalist salaries went up dramatically. And when your salary goes up, believe me, you have a vested interest not to rock the boat. Fact of the matter is that you make money, the house makes money, but the profession gets undermined and compromised.
While liberalization had completely changed the business model of newspapers in India, over in America, these guys were changing the television news landscape with Fox News. Along with CNN, it was one of the first channels to really embrace the 24/7 news cycle and was based on an underlying idea that news needed to double as entertainment. Matlab ekdam bhadakte hue graphics, flashier segment titles, and the news got more opinionated.
I know what
shut
I was
up.
Doing.
Shut up.
Please don't tell me to shut up.
Why didn't you just shut up?
And it is our duty as loyal Americans to shut up.
Stop the BS here. Stop the crap.
Wo jo news ticker hota hai na, wo inhone hi shuru kiya tha. Fox introduced a style of news that was politically driven, leaning hard to the right with in-your-face commentary and heated debates.
You know this it. Is justice.
This has nothing to do with that poor old mayor.
You
this
want
nothing to do no. with that man.
You are lying here.
Wo pehla aisa channel tha that realized that TV news was the perfect medium for making propaganda profitable. And it was the beginning of people going into their own echo chambers, listening to things that conformed with their own political thinking.
And it's not white on black crime that's the problem. It's black on black crime that is causing social chaos.
The Quran is being used to justify murder. It's being used to justify mothers and fathers strapping suicide vests on their own children and promising them 72 virgins in heaven.
Kisi ki yaad aayi? Maybe this guy?
Chup kyun ho, Salman?
So back home in India, the TV landscape was also going through a dramatic change. And because of the liberalized access to communication technology, India mein foreign companies ka ek sehlab sa aane laga. Aur jo existing Indian companies thi, they also started entering new industries, including television. Initially, the rise in the number of news channels was a great thing. Ab newspapers ke saath saath, TV news could also question the government and talk about issues of public interest. It was a highly competitive space where everyone wanted to do better than the other.
Star News.
But as the years went on, Indian television mein itne sare channel aa gaye ki news channels weren't just competing with other news channels for our attention. They were also competing with Kasauti Zindagi ki and Indian Idol. Aur Kasauti Zindagi ki jagah news kisko dekhni hai yaar? This is when Arnab made a move and brought the Fox News model to India.
Take off the mic and leave this.
मेरी बात मत सुनिए. आप
सबूत दिखाइए.
I've run out of patience with you.
Don't try to patronize me.
All right, tell me what is the question, Mr. Liar?
I don't want to know your legislative rubbish. Don't show me your temper on television, okay?
Arnab understood the English-speaking middle class's disdain for the political class, and he used it to his advantage. He would take on the mighty politicians and bureaucrats on his show, and that gave the middle class a sense of catharsis.
When I joined Times Now at that time, there were many political leaders that nobody would touch, nobody would write about, nobody would shower mic on their face and ask questions which were not reverent enough. So that culture was changed when a lot of channels came together, and there was an irreverence which crept into television reporting, which is nobody was beyond questioning.
Had you not been a Gandhi, would you have been in politics?
मैं भी तो माइग्रेंट हाँ तो मैं वही तो बोल रहा हूँ मैं लेकिन तुम्हारा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है ना जब प्रॉब्लम करोगे तो राज ठाकरे उठेगा ना
कांग्रेस पार्टी आपको बचाने की कोशिश कर रही है कई लोग कैबिनेट में है अप्रैल 14 यू से प्रियंका गांधी हैज अग्रीड टू कंटेस्ट द वाराणसी सीट On April 23rd, it becomes Priyanka Vadra.
Well, that's how
Miss Priyanka Vadra should not be.
To be fair, he was half decent at this point. Even though he made a spectacle out of it, at least he was talking about things that mattered. Gradually, he carefully created an image for himself as an editor who openly takes sides, moving away from the traditional view that gives the audience both sides of a story and lets them decide. He killed the nuance for black and white answers with instant and populist judgments that audiences love.
Because you are unable to respond to their points, you are making personal points on them. No.
You are more dangerous to this country than Maoist terrorists.
Nobody has a right to say my country is intolerant. My country is not intolerant.
Why don't these Pakistani stars take a position on terrorism?
Congratulations. You will be the hero of the Pakistani media today, Atul Kumar Anjar.
So students booked for celebrating the life of a terrorist, instead of handing themselves to the authorities, should dictate terms to the police about how their arrest should be carried out. Wonderful.
But the underlying idea of this new brand of news was always entertainment.
Now, I still remember that in our editorial meetings, we were told that news is also entertainment at times. So what you're doing is infotainment. We were told that the camera people will not use tripods anymore. They will actually lift their big cameras, keep it on the shoulder, and they will shoot. So it seems to the audience that there's a sense of urgency in that shoot, that there is some sort of excitement happening, behind the reporter.
अब news जितनी ज़्यादा entertaining होती है, उतने ज़्यादा लोग उसको देखते हैं, which in turn leads to the channel getting higher television rating points or TRP.
And for those who don't understand how ratings work, it's very simple. There's something called a barometer, which is fixed around 50,000 houses in India. So the ratings are dependent on what these 50,000 households watch. So if you're a household where a barometer is kept and you're four people in your house, there are different remotes. There's one remote for a 20 plus male. Let's say there's a 40 plus female in your house. There is a 2 plus year old kid. There are separate remotes for each person. And when they switch on, it's recorded in the rating. But it's been known for many years that ratings are rigged in many manners. And now, of course, it's become a matter of investigation.
Now, however flawed it is, the TRP determines the price of the ads that run on these channels. So the higher the TRP, the more money the channel makes. And in his search for higher TRPs, over the years, Arnab got crazier.
I want to know where you were then. I want to know where you were. Don't be an anti-national. Don't be an anti-national.
And crazier.
Cheek, cheek, kar chillaunga.
Kuch bhi. Kuch bhi.
And crazier. But because of Arnab's success, soon most channels changed their style.
आपको पता है आपकी असली हैसियत क्या है? आज के बाद Zee News ZMCL के खिलाफ एक शब्द मत बोलिएगा।
बिल्कुल। बड़े और छोटे, आपका सर्टिफिकेट नहीं चाहिए और आगे से ऐसी हिमाकत दिखाइएगा मत।
Not only was it a sure shot way to ensure that news became entertaining, ये ज़्यादा सस्ता भी पड़ता था। All they had to do was sit in the studio and express their outrage on the situation of the day, and they had to send less reporters into the field. रेटिंग्स बढ़ गई, खर्चा कम हो गया, तो पैसा ही पैसा।
They may call themselves news anchors and बड़ा गंभीर चेहरा करके कोट वोट पहन के बड़े गंभीर प्रश्न वगैरह करेंगे, but essentially that entire thing is structured and we know that. And those are the gaps which are suddenly revealed, when वो जो सुनने वाला, वो जो इंटरव्यू ही होता है, वो अचानक बोलता है क्या बकवास कर रहा है, and he goes away. ये सब उस गैप को दिखाता है कि ये पहले स्ट्रक्चर्ड था और वो इट डिडंट गो द वे इट वाज स्ट्रक्चर्ड. वो जो सामने बैठा वाला था ही टुक कंट्रोल एंड देन दे फाउंड कि इस बात का भी न्यूज है कि हाउ एन एंकर वाज अब्यूज्ड.
ऊपर से एवरी चैनल वांटेड टू बी द फर्स्ट वन टू ब्रेक न्यूज, सो देयर वाज नो टाइम फॉर वेरिफिकेशन. With no actual on-ground reporting and verification of news, this was the beginning of the post-truth era, an era where the arguments were based on the anchors' emotions and beliefs rather than actual facts.
Earlier, when there were only newspapers, I only consumed news in the morning, then when I was traveling, and then I forgot about the news. Then news, wo Doordarshan news aayi, so I only consumed news at 7 p.m. देन धीरे धीरे वो दोपहर को करते फिर सवेरे को. अब 24 घंटे और यू नो ऑन द मोबाइल फोन ऑन द सो द न्यूज साइकिल इज ब्रोकन. देयर इज नो न्यूज साइकिल. दैट गेट कीपिंग फंक्शन इज गोइंग ऑरी. वी आर पुटिंग डायरेक्टली इनटू लाइव फीड एंड विच इज व्हाई दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हैपन. कि वो पोस्टमैन को हम पूछ रहे हैं कि बिल्डिंग क्यों खोली और वो कह रहे मैं पोस्टमैन हूँ. उसकी छाती पे दिख रहा है पर क्यों नहीं रुका, क्योंकि गेट कीपर नहीं है. जो वहां पे शूट हो रहा था डायरेक्टली फीड पे गया है. नॉर्मली एक गेट कीपर होता और वो देखता, वो चेक करता कि क्या कट करना है, क्या रखना है. गेटकीपिंग नहीं हो रहा है बिकॉज़ हम दुनिया की न्यूज़ साइकिल में अपने आप को घुसाने की कोशिश.
व्हाइल टीवी न्यूज़ हैड बीन टर्न्ड इनटू इंफोटेनमेंट बाय कॉर्पोरेशंस टू मेक मोर मनी, वी वर स्टार्टिंग टू रिवर्ट बैक टू द ओल्ड सिस्टम ऑफ यूजिंग मीडिया एज प्रोपेगेंडा.
भारतीय लोकतंत्र का इतिहास अपने नेपोलियन को देख रहा है.
दिस इज एक्साइटिंग,
लुक एट दिस, इट्स ऑल सैफ्रन वेस्ट टू ईस्ट विद फ्यू पॉकेट्स ऑफ ग्रीन.
प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी सुबह 7:30 बजे तक तैयार हो जाते हैं. उसके बाद नाश्ता करते हैं जो कि होता है बहुत हल्का, कभी पोहा कभी भाकरी तो कभी खाखरा.
मोदी का फिटनेस फंडा ऐसा है कि डॉक्टरों का दिमाग भी घूमने लगता है.
While some politicians started their own news channels or invested in upcoming ones, others formed a mutually beneficial relationship with corporate media and their promoters. For example, Zee News is owned by Subhash Chandra, who is a BJP MP. Republic TV is owned by Arnab Goswami, who, let's just say, has a thing for Modi ji. Arnab's father, Manoranjan Goswami, was also a member of the BJP. By the way, Manoranjan Goswami is a great nickname for Arnab. Also, it was co-founded by Rajiv Chandrasekhar, who is now a BJP MP. Network 18 is owned by Mukesh Ambani, and the India Today Group is owned by Arun Puri. Their affiliations keep changing depending on who's in power. Currently, they seem to be chaddi buddies with the BJP. NDTV is owned by Pranoy Roy and Radhika Roy, whose sister is a member of CPIM. India TV is owned by Rajat Sharma, former General Secretary of ABBP. And News 24 is owned by Rajiv Shukla, who was the Secretary of the All India Congress Committee. अब इसमें होता क्या है कि ये channels news का अपना अपना variation सुना रहे होते हैं. तो ये पहले से डिसाइडेड होता है कि एक न्यूज़ को कैसे दिखाएंगे क्या नहीं दिखाएंगे, और इसी के मुताबिक फिर डिबेट्स के पार्टिसिपेंट्स चूज किए जाते हैं. सो दे आर ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू पुश देयर ओन नैरेटिव.
ये हॉस्टल की 300 रुपए महीने की फीस नहीं देना चाहते, इसलिए इतना प्रदर्शन कर रहे हैं. अब तक ये छात्र सिर्फ 10 रुपए महीने में JNU के हॉस्टल में रहा करते थे.
पहले रूम रेंट 10 रुपए था जो अब 300 रुपए हो गया. लेकिन आप 12,000 रुपए कमाने वाले परिवार के हिसाब से देखिए, तब आप इस 10 रुपए पर हंसना बंद कर देंगे.
इफ अमेरिका कैन हैव द इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ ए CAA, व्हाई इज इट दैट इंडिया व्हेन इट पासेस द CAA इज बीइंग अक्यूज्ड टुडे ऑफ मूविंग टुवर्ड्स ए हिंदू राष्ट्र.
For the first time, the citizenship of India is being linked to religion. We are saying, if you want to come from outside, no Muslims please, thank you. That is the sense of this legislation.
Himmat kaise hui tablighi jamaat ki? Kis tarah se corona phaila hai is desh mein?
Jab dhara 144 दिल्ली में लगी हुई है, पूरा बंद चल रहा है, लॉकडाउन चल रहा है, तो दिल्ली पुलिस को क्यों नहीं मालूम पड़ा कि ये लोग यहाँ पर इतनी भारी तादाद में है.
Another way political parties control news is through advertising. Political and government advertising makes up a huge chunk of the advertising revenue of any TV or print news organization. For example, BJP by far spends the most money on advertising. अब क्योंकि करंटली सरकार भी उन्हीं की है, सो दे ऑल्सो कंट्रोल हु गेट्स गवर्नमेंट एडवर्टाइजिंग. तो अगर कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बीजेपी या गवर्नमेंट के खिलाफ कुछ बोलना चाहे तो वो 10 बार सोचते हैं, बिकॉज पैसा सबको कमाना है. दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ नाइटली डिबेट्स यू सी ऑन दीज चैनल्स आर फोकस्ड ऑन ट्रिवियल थिंग्स रादर देन थिंग्स ऑफ पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट. जैसे साफ पानी और हवा या बेरोजगारी। तो अब इंफोटेनमेंट और पॉलिटिकल प्रोपेगेंडा के बीच में न्यूज चैनल्स पे न्यूज बहुत कम बची है। एंड इफ ऑल ऑफ दिस वाजंट बैड इनफ, द राइज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया हैज बीन अनदर किक टू द नट्स ऑफ जर्नलिज्म। अगले एपिसोड में देखिए फेसबुक और गूगल का वार जर्नलिज्म से।